control that move. You gotta be a good partner. You can't be a bad partner with that. You gotta sprawl into him. You gotta sprawl and, like, square up with him. Half the time practice, you're a drill partner. So if you get a bad drill partner, 50% of the time, you're getting worse. So make sure you guys are good drill partners. Waiting on Bernie to get up here. Okay. I normally try to go from a single leg right away from that, but I do hit the cut back more just because college wrestling, everyone's stopping your first move. But if I can't get a cut back, I go right back to the single leg. So I'll show you what I do. Obviously, climb the arms, move them, reach in, shot, he sprawls. Sometimes you can't get the cut back because, like, he knows you're going to cut back, so as soon as you do it, he's going to sprawl his leg back and forth, even farther and flatten me out. Yeah, like this. So now I'm stuck underneath here. So from right here, you're in really bad position because you're extended and your arms are out. From here, I try to get my lock to the mat just to give me some traction. So when I get there, I get my lock to the mat, push up, push into him. Don't push up, don't push back, don't pull back. Push into him. Then I slide my lock. All I need is a couple inches. I get his lock a couple inches, and all I do is I take his elbow and I slam it to the mat over there. I slam it and I kick his leg. Kick right here. Right here, I'm in a little bit better position. Circle.
Hey, Hunter, turn, spin around, Hunter. Yeah, keep spinning. So they can see. Keep moving. All the way around. Keep going again.
Right. Real quick, you see, my shoulder's out. This is not good. I'm not in a very good position. So I'll show you how I get that back in. So, right here. I'm right here. Foot back. I'm in a pretty good position. My shoulder's out, so he still has advantage. There. I dip my shoulder, and I extend this arm. It goes flat like this. And I try to crawl over here. That gives me better position, and my shoulder just slips behind. The process of getting my shoulder behind that leg is going to give me a score. From there, my lock's done, but I keep it tight. I'm tight. And I'm switching, I'm grabbing down here, grabbing the ankle, anything I can, I grab it and I pull out just a little bit. That will break his key lock or whatever you want to call it, it'll break that. And if he's really strong, you just gotta pull onto it, and you can push up right here, and that extends even more. And if he's really good at fighting to you, you can bring it to the mat. I'll show you after this. So right here, pull it, I get it, right there, I get my shoulder even more, and I reach across. I try to grab his ankle. I don't like reaching up because I saw long ago that you're going to get pulled right here. It's not good. So I reach for the ankle and I just drive across. Drive across, try to bundle up both legs so it's an easier breakdown. I like finishing on the mat more. That's why most of my finishing is on the mat. But in college, in a really good competition, kids are going to fight nonstop. So get it. Shot. It sprawls out. Extended, pull it into you. Just gotta get a little bit. You'll push into him, pulling. You slam that elbow down and kick this leg around so he can't grab it. There, you keep scooting. One thing I forgot is you gotta get this knee right here over here to the side of the foot. Help you drag it, help you pull it. Just extend your arm out. Help break the lock. But he's good. He's gonna fight into you. So when you extend a lot and you push up, he's gonna stand up with you. So you do it, he stands up. Now you're in good position because you're up here. Got a good lock, and you trip them. So you can finish up top. I like finishing on bottom. Whatever you guys feel comfortable with, you guys can do. Guys, any questions? All right. Let's go. One, two.